Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the fuzzy set theory. Today we will discuss about what are the various extensions of the fuzzy set which are used for solving the decision making problems such as multi attributes, multi category and so on. Myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me through either of my email IDs if you feel any hesitation regarding the fuzzy set theory. Or you can simply click on this my YouTube channel link, where you can find the several videos related to their research task is there. So let's start with this video. So before explaining this extension of the fuzzy set, I will explain you why there is a need of the fuzzy set theory and where you can see in our day-to-day life. For example, in any of the decision-making problems, our task is to what is my objective, what is my criteria, and what are my alternative. What is the meaning of that? Suppose you want to select a car. So if you go to the market and you want to select a car, so how many brands of the cars are available in that? That is called my alternatives. Like say, you can buy either of the Honda City car, you can buy either a Tata, Ford or Maruti are there. And once you are selecting either of the car, then what parameters you have considered in your mind or what criteria you have considered in your mind, you want a good stylish car, you want a good reliability, you want a fuel economy, you want a cost to be in the reasonable and so on. So in order to assess such type of the problem, the decision is not always be the unique. So therefore, you can construct a matrix like this way. What is the meaning is A1. I call as A1 is my Honda City, A2 is my Tata, A3 is my Ford, A4 is my Maruti. And style C1, criteria C2, C3 and so on. What is the meaning of the X11 is if a person want to select the Honda City car with the parameter of the style, they give some rating, that is evaluation of the alternative AI under the criteria CJ. So if this XIJ, whatever is that, is a unique number, is always be a unique number, or you can call as a Cripps number, then we call as the Cripps set theory. But if someone can give this number as a 0.7, someone can give as a 0.8, so it has occurs in the terms of several uncertainty. So in order to measure this, we need the fuzzy set theory. So the information provided in the fuzzy set theory lies between 0 1, and the task is to provide this rating or evaluation of the xij for each of the alternatives. So if the information is provided in terms of their numbers, which is called as the membership degree, which are lies between 0 to 1, is called as the membership degree, and the pairs called as the x comma membership, that is a tuple x is there, is called as the fuzzy set. And if you think about that, instead of this, it can also be written like this way here, or it can also be written as here. So remember that this is not the divide set, this is just the representation of this. What is the meaning of that? A set consists of the element my 2 4 6 and 8. Now this point 3 means the element 4 belong to the set is 30% is there and so on. Once you are defining the A and B, and A, this is the membership. Membership is called as the acceptance degree, or you can say called as the favorable degree. So once you are assigning the favorable degree, then you can easily assign the union. So union is always give the maximum of them. So look at that, the number here is 2. What is the maximum membership degrees? 1 or 0.5 is 1. So that's why this is a 1. Similarly, if you look at that, corresponding to 6, this is a 0.5, this is a 0.1, the maximum is 0.5. Similarly, you can find the values corresponding to their intersection. So how you define the values of corresponding to the intersection? That is nothing but my minimum. So you can take the minimum of them. If you take the complement, then you can define like this. So this is nothing but 1 minus. But in this fuzzy set theory, all are focused on this acceptance degree, but they are not working on the complement of them. So that's why we are needing of the extensions. So there are the several extensions we will discuss here. First one is the intuistic fuzzy set, which came into the picture is 1986. After that, interval valued, then hesitant, then the dual hesitant. All are working on the intuistic fuzzy environment. Later on, some Pythagorean fuzzy set will came into the picture, which is in the 2013. By Zegar in Pythagorean fuzzy set. In that 2018, myself presented the hesitant fuzzy set. Again, in that 2018, myself presented the linguistic Pythagorean fuzzy set. Further, neutrophic set is present in the 2010, which we also discuss in this video. Later on, in the recently year 2019 and 2020, myself again presented the linguistic interval-valued intrinsic and the linguistic interval-valued Pythagorean. So let's discuss one by one in detail. So remember that my task is to provide the rating of these each of the Xij. So if the persons will provide this rating in terms of the two pairs, membership and non-membership, this means this is the pair of the agreeness, this is the pair of the disagreeness. So if the persons are representing this rating in terms of their agreeness and disagreeness, then we call this pair as intuistic fuzzy set. Make sure that this rating is my again a Cripps number. For example, if I say rating is my 0.8 and 0.2, it means person is 80% is believe that the thing is good, while 20% is believe that the thing is not good. Also, in other words, if somebody say the 0.7 and 0.1, the person believe that the 70% is the thing is good, 10% is the thing is bad. What about the remaining one? That is the 20% is. So there is a hesitation. So that's why this hesitation is called as the hesitation is we denoted as a pi, which is nothing but my difference of them. So where mu is called as the degree of membership, nu is called as the degree of non-membership, provided that the sum will be less than of one. It means this pair, it can't be acceptable in case of intuistic fuzzy set because the sum is not be a less than one. After that, there is a need of the interval valued. Why? Because if someone provides this rating value x11 in terms of their intervals. So if I say, if someone asks you how the good the thing are there, so if they are not providing the numbers in terms of the Cripps, but they provide the information in terms of the interval, like say 0.7 to 8, and the degree of disagreeness is say 1 to 2. What is the meaning is, he believes that the thing is good up to the 70 and 80% is, anything lies between them, and the thing is bad up to the 10 to 20% is are there. So that's why we call as the upper, L is a lower, U is the upper, that's right in the form of intervals. So if they are pair in the form of the interval numbers, we call as the interval valued intuistic fuzzy set. Why we call as the intuistic fuzzy set? Because there is a restrictions on their upper bounds. So since this is a restriction on the sum of them is less than of the one, so that's why this is called as the intuistic fuzzy set, and the ratings are provided in terms of the interval, we call as interval valued intuistic fuzzy set. Similarly, if someone provide this rating instead of the interval numbers, they can provide more than one values, because in case of the intuistic fuzzy set or interval valued intuistic fuzzy set, each person can assign the single value. But if someone asks you that they is good about 0.7 and 0.75, remember that this is entirely different from here. How many points are there in between? They are infinitely many, but it consists of only two values. Similarly, if someone provides more than two values, for that they need some another set. We firstly discuss what is the operations of them. Again, this is the addition set, this is the maximum and minimum, while on in terms of multiplication, there is the minimum and the maximum are there. And based on them, you can define this algebraic probability. All of you know that how you define the A union B. This is probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of intersection. Based on them, it can be defined like this way. Similarly, this is the Einstein operation and so on. The importance of this Einstein operation is to increase the importance of membership degree. Or you can say increase the importance of the agreeness. You can see this number is always be greater than of this number. So that's why importance is on the membership. Now, another thing is the hesitant fuzzy set. It will provide the discrete membership degrees. It provides the discrete. Meaning is that if I say, if I rate these values in terms of say 0.5, 50%, say 60% or say 55, it means it provides exactly of the three values are there. I can't say this number is same as that of 0.5 to 0.6. Why? Because it 0.52 also lies in between them. But in case of the discrete number, it always be a proper discrete number. So the definition is, it consists for all the x, there exists some pairs. This pair is called as the hesitant fuzzy elements, such that each of the number lies between 0, 1. And this h of a is called as the membership degree. And similarly, based on these operations, if you have the three hesitant fuzzy elements are there, then you can define the complement as 1 minus, because it consists only for the agreeness, that is a membership degree. How you define the minimum intersection, nothing but the minimum. Union is nothing but the maximum, and addition and multiply are there. Again, you can see that in the hesitant fuzzy set, they are considered only for the agreeness, but they are totally against for the disagreeness. So how you, if you consider agreeness and disagreeness both, then you have to define the concept of the next extension called as dual hesitant fuzzy set. What is the meaning of that? It consists of two pairs, H and G, where H is called as the membership degree, G is called as the non-membership degree. So if you set G as nothing but 1 minus H, so then it becomes my hesitant fuzzy set. So based on this, and again H and G are my discrete values called as membership, and non-membership lies between 0, 1. For example, and the condition on the H and G here, because this is the sum, these are the two, membership and non-membership. So the condition will be that the maximum of their sum will be less than of 1. What is the meaning of that is, if I consider the two elements A and B, if I rate this value, like say, what is the meaning is, a person rate about the object that 40% is, 50% is, or the 55%. These are exactly three values. While 20 and 30% he believe that it is disagree. Similarly for here. Now what is the maximum value of this is? 0.50. What is the maximum value of the non-membership is? Here. So this is my gamma positive. So what is the gamma positive for A? 0.55. What is the eta positive for the A? 0.3. What is the gamma positive for the B is? What is the maximum value is? 0.83. What is the eta positive of this is? 1.5. If their sum will be less than of 1, then we call this pair as my dual hesitant fuzzy set pairs. Otherwise, not. Again, now there are the two pairs, so we can define the operations. What is the opposite of them? What is the complement? If I say there are the pair of the agreeness and disagreeness, what is the complement of this? What is the complement this? It means the disagreeness and agreeness. So you can see these are the opposite. Similarly, how you define the union? Agreeness will be maximum, disagreeness will be minimum. On the other hand, how you define their intersection is, disagreeness is maximum, agreeness is minimum. And similarly, you can define the products as well as their addition operation. Another, these are all about the this one. So make sure that the restriction about them on their interval, on their preferences are there. Later on, now we will discuss about the Pythagorean fuzzy sets, and these are the extensions. For example, if someone provides these ratings like here, 0.7 and 0.4, you can clearly see that this number is not be less than of the 1. So therefore, this rating is not be corresponding to the intuitive fuzzy set. So this is the drawback of the intuitive fuzzy set, that the domain of the intuitive fuzzy set is very limited. Such type of the ratings are not acceptable. So in order to handle this, the Pythagorean fuzzy set is introduced. Again, these are the pair of the membership and non-membership provided. Their ratings are, square of their ratings will be less than of 1. So if you clearly see about that, these are the condition for the intuitive fuzzy set. These are the conditions for the Pythagorean fuzzy set. So if you draw the graph of this first one, so this is the rating, this is the feasible area. And if you rate them on this second part, this will be the quadratic one. So, and you can see this red color, feasible area of the Pythagorean fuzzy set is more than of the intuitive fuzzy set. It means the more the decision makers as preferences are satisfied more in case of Pythagorean fuzzy set and then of the intuitive fuzzy set. So this is one of the advantages of this Pythagorean fuzzy set. Similarly, once you are defining like this way, so 0.7 and 0.4 are my degrees. So what is that? You can see that 0.7 plus this is less than 1, but it is not exactly equal to 1. So what's the remaining part is? We call as the degree of indeterminacy still, or called as the hesitancy degree. Based on this Pythagorean fuzzy set, you can define some operations as we have defined in the intuitive fuzzy sets: addition, subtraction, scalar multiply, and their scalar power system. Later on, if preferences, if I say x11, So this hesitant fuzzy set is the extension of the dual hesitant fuzzy set. What is the dual hesitant fuzzy set? Is we can rate this element in terms of their 2 degrees, whereas the discrete, such that maximum of this and the maximum of the non-membership will be less than 1. But now in the hesitant fuzzy set, which is introduced by me in 2018, such that the square of their membership degree and square of their non-membership degree will be less than 1. For example, if someone can provide the rating as 0.75 and say 0.3, and the non-membership degrees are say 0.1, 0.2 and so on, then clearly says that what is the gamma positive of them? This is 0.83. What is the maximum of this? Is 0.2, and their sum is not be less than 1. So it means this rating is not be related to the dual hesitant fuzzy set. So this is the drawback of the dual hesitant fuzzy set. So we can overcome this with the help of this Pythagorean fuzzy set condition, and you can easily see that this condition will satisfied. So therefore you can say, if this condition satisfied, then you can say this is the hesitant Pythagorean fuzzy set, otherwise not. And the special cases of them are there. If none of the elements are there, it means 0 and 0, phi, we call as the non-sensational elements. If agreeness will totally be 0, disagreement is 1, we call as the completely uncertainty. If fully agreement is there, that is a 1, we call as the certainty. If it is, now look at that, this is infinitely many points are there. It is not be the set. So therefore, this is called as the complete ill known conditions. Another set is called as the linguistic Pythagorean fuzzy set. What is the meaning is that if I say how much beautiful this picture is there, if I just draw this picture, how much beautiful is there? So you can't represent them, it's a 70% is beautiful. Because whenever there is a terms of the linguistic variables like intelligence, like taste, like honesty and so on, these are the variables which you can measure in the form of qualitative, not for the quantitative. So in for this such type of the problem, you always measure in terms of the qualitative, like how much good is there. So you can say it's a good, it's a poor, it's a average, it's a moderate and so on. So you always rate them in terms of this. So whenever your ratings are in terms of good, poor and so on, then you are always preferring the linguistic set. So what is that? So if I rate this element is in terms of their good or poor or very good, very poor, etc., that is the linguistic pairs. So I called as S1, S2, S3. S1 is called as my good, S2 is my poor, S3 is my very poor and so on. So we called, whenever ratings are like this way, then we define the linguistic Pythagorean fuzzy set like say this. The first part is called as the membership degree, but we call as the linguistic membership degree. Second part is called as the non-membership degree. And since it is a Pythagorean fuzzy set, so we have to define this condition must be less than of the maximum power. So because I define S1, S2, S3. So what is the maximum is I call as the S of T, then it will be less than of T square. Look at that. So this pair is called as the linguistic Pythagorean fuzzy number. So which is introduced in reference number 6 in 2018 by me. So you can watch if you want. Again, you can define the operation of them. So the two linguistic set will be equal when their ratings are same. Complement is again similar and these are operations are there. Now the next extension is on the single value neutrosophic set. So the major advantages of the neutrosophic set over the other sets are there. In this, all of you have seen that in the intuistic fuzzy set, the degrees are here. In the Pythagorean fuzzy set, the map relation is there. So you can see this mu and nu are dependent on each other. Why? Because if you know the value of mu as a 0.3, so then you can easily see the value of this will be less than or equal to 7. Similarly, if mu is 0.3 here, you can find the maximum value of there. It means these both are dependent on each other. While in this neutrosophic set, all the degrees are independent to each other. It means, what is the meaning is, they consider of the 3 degrees, one is the membership, this first one is the membership, I call this as, this first one is called as the membership, second, third one is called as the non-membership, and this one is called as indeterminacy. What is the meaning of that? I will tell you. And the sum, since they are all independent, it lies between 0, 1. And due to independence, the sum will be, maximum sum will be the 3. For example, what is the meaning is, neither the fuzzy set nor the intuitive fuzzy set or the Pythagorean fuzzy set able to deal with this intermediate or inconsistent information, that is about this parameter. How? We can see, for example, so if the person gives their rating about the object that 0.5 being the statement is true, so it means they are talking about the agreeness. So it means this value is called as my membership. Similarly, if someone say that 70% degree is the false, it means they are disagreeness. So this 70% is my non-membership. And thirdly, if someone talk about that 20%, he or she is not sure about that. Because whenever we are talking about the decision in our day-to-day life, we always give the three ratings. First one, we agree. Second one is we disagree. And the third one is we may or may not be sure. Or we can say we are not sure about that. So since they are the three different pairs, so we represent this set as, these are called as the agreeness, called as the membership. Second one is called as the non-membership. And third one is called as the hesitancy or indeterminacy. Also, you can write this pair as 0.5, 0.2, 0.7. So make sure that this is the, now this is the non-membership, this is the membership, and this is the indeterminacy. So that's the advantages of the nitrosophic set. And look at that, the sum will be less than of the 3. So if any of the condition in your day-to-day life, if you are work on the decision which are not sure about that, then that set is corresponding to the nitrosophic set. And this part not sure is not considered on the intuitive fuzzy set or the Pythagorean fuzzy set. So this is the simple extensions of the of all the fuzzy sets are there. And based on these extensions, you can easily solve the various MCDM problem. Make sure that you have to provide the decision matrix like X11, X12 and so on, based on your expert's preferences. Once you will collect all these preferences, you can apply the aggregation operator, distance measure, correlation and so on. So we will discuss all this in our next video. And if you want to find the references are there, so these are the interval value in intuitive fuzzy set, intuitive fuzzy set, dual hesitant fuzzy set, this is the hesitant Pythagorean fuzzy set myself, this is the linguistic Pythagorean fuzzy set, this is a single value nitrosophic set by, and so on. This is a famous they will propose the fuzzy set is there in 1965. If you find some another videos related to this fuzzy set or the research purpose, you can simply browse this link and you can share this video to the other researchers also for the more benefit. Till then, best of luck students, happy learning.